beautiful.
You had the right kind of choice. And we just invite you to bless this family. In Jesus' name. Help her.
Reading in Ephesians 5:25, it says, "Husbands, love your wife, just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her." You're to love Sarah in a way that is deeper than you can ever imagine. It's through the hard times, through the good times, through the rich times, to the poor times, it's sickness and in health, and all kinds of other times that will occur in your marriage. Christ died on the cross so that you might have life, and Sarah might have life, and all of us could experience salvation. But he died a horrible death on the cross. He gave himself for the church. You lay down your life for your wife, just as Christ did for the church. It's a very, very deep statement, and you'll learn more about it as you get a little older. It's not always easy, but it's always worth it. Sarah, I was looking at Ephesians 5:22, where it says, "Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord." I know you love the Lord. We talked about that last week when we got together, and I know you've loved the Lord for a long time. The Bible says that you should love your husband very much as you love your Lord. You love Jesus with all your heart. She's shaking her head yes. And you are to love him. Now, the Lord, he never makes mistakes. But I'll just tell you right now that Evan will make a few mistakes. Not many. I'm sure not many. But he will make a few mistakes. And when he does, you are to love him just as you love the Lord.
Upon Evan.
And then Evan and Sarah together, I look at the 33rd verse, which says this: "Nevertheless, let each one of you in particular so love his wife as himself, and let the wife see that she respects her husband." Evan, your job was to do what Christ did for the church, but it's even more so and more practical than that. It's to love Sarah. A woman needs love. In the morning, when you talk to her throughout the day, when you go to bed at night, you need to tell her, "I love you." It'll mean a lot to her. Women are built like that. I don't understand women. You won't understand women. Nobody in this audience, none of you men, can tell me that you understand men, women, because they don't. We don't. But you are to love. You can trust the Word of God. And the Word of God says you are to love her no matter what the circumstance is. And then Sarah, it says, "And let the wife see that she respects her husband." It just keeps going. And it just gets better and better that you love her day by day, year by year, decade by decade, hopefully for many decades. As you love her and you respect him, you will have a marriage that other folks really won't understand. How could they have such a good marriage? Because you follow the Word of God. You loved her. You respected him. A man needs to be respected. And then I was looking at the 31st verse, which says this: "For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh." Evan, you've had a very close relationship with your parents as you've grown up, and I know that, Sarah, you've had a close relationship with your mom and dad, but now it's time to leave. Sometimes I see the couples make a mistake of kind of holding on to their parents or their parents holding on to them, and you've got to break loose. It says, a man and woman shall leave their father and mother and cleave to each other and become one. It's a very deep teaching. It's a very deep thing that you're entering into. But God intends you to become one. When one hurts, both of you hurt. But when one has the joy is actually doubled. And when you're hurt, you only have to suffer half the hurt because you're suffering together. And the joy double, triple, quadruple. It just gets better when you share joys together. And Lord willing, you'll have more joys than you do sadness in your marriage if you follow the Word of God. Jesus said this, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. You know what? If you do that, both of you will be very, very happy in this life. And you also very, very happy, married together. Let's pray. Well, Father, thank you so much for this couple on this wonderful, wonderful day. Thank you for the cool weather that you blessed us with in answer to prayer. And thank you for bringing them together from actually different one side of the earth to the other side of the earth. You brought. Oh, Lord, thank you for this day. And thank you for the life together that we're getting today. In Jesus' name, amen. one more admonition to you as a couple. Since marriage is ordained of God, and it's based upon the love of God, your home can, above all other institutions, bless humanity and honor the Lord. You are therefore exhorted to dedicate to live with her according to God's ordinance. Will you love her as Christ loved the church, giving yourself for her? Will you be kind, compassionate, and forgiving, as in Christ God forgives you? And will you keep yourself for her alone so long as you both shall live?
I will.
Sarah, will you take this man in the marriage covenant to live with him according to God's ordinance? Will you submit to him as unto the Lord? And will you be kind and compassionate and forgiving as in Christ God forgives you? And will you keep yourself for him alone so long as you both shall live? Would you turn to each other and hold hands, please? Evan, repeat after me. I, Evan,
take you, Sarah,
to be my wife,
in the sight of our Lord Jesus Christ.
I promise to be faithful,
in suffering and in joy,
in poverty and in wealth,
in sickness and in health.
I promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
And cherish your companionship.
And cherish your companionship.
Till death alone.
Till death alone.
Brings our separation.
Brings our separation.
Sarah, would you repeat after me? I, Sarah.
I, Sarah.
Take you, Evan.
Take you, Evan.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
In the sight of our Lord Jesus Christ.
In the sight of our Lord Jesus Christ.
I promise to be faithful.
I promise to be faithful.
In suffering and in joy.
In poverty and in wealth.
In sickness and in health.
I promise to obey and
cherish.
Your companionship.
Till death alone.
Brings our separation.
The circle. The emblem of eternity symbolizes the endurance of your covenant. And gold, a substance of beauty and increasing value, is to show the lasting covenant and enduring relationship into which you're entering. Since this union is to be severed only by death, it becomes you to consider the duties you solemnly assume. If these duties are remembered and faithfully discharged, they'll add to the happiness of your life together. Their performance will lighten sorrows and heighten blessings, but their neglect and violation will produce keen misery and heavy guilt. Evan, the duties of the husband will be discovered by searching the scriptures to discover how Christ loved the church. The duties of the wife, Sarah, will be discovered by searching the scripture to determine how the church is to be submissive to the Lord. And it's the duty of both of you to delight in the companionship of the other and to remember that henceforth you shall be one, and to see to it that what God has joined together, no man can separate. Father, bless Evan and Sarah as they give and exchange these rings. May it provide a constant reminder of their pledge to each other. Amen. Did you put the ring on her finger. Repeat after me. I give you this ring, Sarah.
I give you this ring, Sarah.
As a perpetual reminder.
As a perpetual reminder.
Of my faithfulness.
Of my faithfulness.
Promised before Almighty God.
Promised before Almighty God.
This day.
This day.
And Sarah, will you receive the ring as a pledge of heaven's fidelity and love to you? And will you wear it as a pledge of your love to him? Sarah, repeat after me. I give you this ring, Evan.
I give you this ring, Evan.
As a perpetual reminder.
As a perpetual reminder.
Of my faithfulness. promise before Almighty God this day.
Promise before Almighty God this day.
Will you, having received this ring, as a pledge of Sarah to you, and will you wear it as a pledge of your love to him?
I will.
Those whom God has joined together, let no man separate. For as much as Evan and Sarah have covenanted together before God in this company and have pledged their faithfulness one to the other, symbolizing this by the giving and receiving of the rings and the joining of their hands, I now, by the authority of the state of Texas, do pronounce them man and wife in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I pray a blessing upon this couple. Of being together, the joy of loving you, and the joy of serving you. Bless this marriage as only you can, O Lord. Amen. All right. A brand new marriage. Evan and Sarah. Gotcha.
The marker on the square says J.H. Hooker, so that's just way back.
Well,
glad y'all came home.
You're going to cut the cake in a few minutes. Can y'all take an intermission?
Okay, then you get right back to work. Man, this is...
There.
Right. Now one tree.
I have groom blushing on the other side.
It's gonna be bad.
I think it was an OD.
Feel free to. I wish we had your special balloons.
I'm gonna be good.
I wish we had your special balloons.
You can tie balloons up here.
I did, but Linda, did you see my subtle way?
Oh yeah.
Where?
It's made.
Right there.
Okay.
Oh my goodness.
That's the subtle.
That is the subtle.
Oh, man.
Yeah, well, they're
going to
need that.
Actually, they're going to tie it over here. Just watch.
That
goes straight down to Roy's car wash.
Oh, it's good. That's good. We'll be on
what
a long
is it,
time.
This goes straight down to Roy's car wash and starts scrubbing.
They better not.
Yeah, we worked way too hard on this, man.
We're going to drive clear across
the
Texas.
We left our stuff on our windows for honeymoon.
Evan's gonna see this footage.
Okay. Evan, I was good. Believe me, this was my. Well, I just came to look. I didn't touch it.
Dan, this is what I expect. Yep. Him to see this, and then so he knows what to do when we get there.
Look at you hiding. Oh, you're right out there. No hiding.
Oh, I think they're cutting the cake, so we have to go.
Yeah,
yeah,
we
gotta go.
Hey, Darcy.
Mommy. She's inside.
Anyway, well, I'll just cut a diagonal. I'll get out of the way and look at the
camera. It's gorgeous.
You really shouldn't start out your wedding day.
Well, John tried, he choked me. I was choking so bad. I thought somebody, paramedics were coming to give me CPR.
Gave me a little too much cake,
that's all right. No, you tried
to steal me.
Thank you.
have to do that again.
Yeah.
Do it again.
You gotta hold that pose so everybody
can. Yeah.
Chug, 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 chug.
I felt something really sharp.
How's it feel, man? You're married.
Cut this.
Feels real different.
Yeah. Oh, man, that's a good ceremony.
Yeah. I'm so glad.
Oh, yeah.
Man, the cakes are just amazing.
Oh, I know. I'm just so impressed with it. That's not what I expected at all.
Yes.
Hello, Sarah.
Yeah. She's
wow.
She's
really good. We're
gonna have thanks.
Yeah, I saw one.
I'm not taking off my glasses till you count.
We could have brought a chair
in front of us.
Yeah, we really should have put that
count before you do it, and I'll take off my sunglasses.
All right. Yeah.
I'm standing on this side of you, and then I'll stand right over you.
Dan, you're
out.
Getting here too.
Yeah, you have to.
Yeah. All right. Whoa.
All right,
Dan.
I want to get one. I couldn't you take one of me with that?
Yeah.
Since I've been shooting.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
See you later, Evan. Yay. All right, you'll have a wonderful time.
Don't be a stranger.
Don't call us.
Unite our bus.
You don't call your family when you're on your honeymoon.
Evan!
Evan! I was just reading what was up.
Evan's already kicking the can.
That's the
other one. No, the other one.
Get the key.
Oh, Peter left.
Rolled down the back window.
You gotta be able to see it. You gotta be able to see out the back window.
I have a pocket knife.
No, don't pop them.
You get a whole bunch of them up at them.
Bye.
Just give the extra to